Basu Nayak, question number 34, exercise. First, I read the question. That is, Mr. Amal Jawardar is the owner of two houses. Both the houses are let out. Here, both the houses are let out. Generally, you don't get this type of question in your HS exam. In HS exam, there will be two house, one is let out, another is self-occupied. But for practice, you can do this. That is, there are two house, both are let out. First one is let out for residence and second one is let out for business. Date of completion of construction is not important for your syllabus. Now, what is given here? Municipal value both for both houses is given. Rent received is given for the both house. Municipal tax is also given. Land revenue, fire insurance, repair. These are not required. Land revenue, fire insurance and repair. These are not required. And vacancy period is mentioned also. That is, for the first house, vacancy period is 1 month. You have to compute income from house property of Mr. Amal Jawardar for the assessment year 2023-24. Now, question number 34. First, you have to write the heading. That is, computation of income from house property of Mr. Amal Jawardar, a resident individual, for the assessment year 2023-24. Relating to the previous year 2022-23. For other year students, you can change this assessment year and previous year. Okay. Now, there are two houses, so we have to draw three amount column. House 1, let out for residence. Given in the question is municipal value, that is 12,000. And other information is not given, that is fair rent or standard rent. So, we are comparing municipal value and annual rent. Now, annual rent is not given in the question. In the question, it is given that rent received is 22,000. And there is a vacancy period of 1 month. So, we have to convert that rent received into annual rent. Here is the workings. Annual rent of H1, that means house 1. 22,000 is the rent received and 1 month is vacancy period. That means rent received is for 11 months. So, we are dividing this 22,000 by 11 and multiplying by 12. You will get 24,000 as an annual rent. And loss due to vacancy is also required. Now, 22,000, another way is you can deduct this 22,000 from 24,000, you will get 2,000 as a vacancy. Another way is that 22,000 is the rent received and this is for 11 months and you have to compute 1 month's vacancy, loss due to vacancy. You are I am multiplying here with 1, that is rupees 2,000. These are two workings. Now comparing these two, that is municipal value 12,000 and annual rent 24,000, we get higher of the above, that is 24,000. No question of reasonable expected rent is there. Now, from this higher of the above two value, that is comparing municipal value and annual rent, we get 24,000. From here, we are deducting loss due to vacancy. We are already computed that. From here, you can see another time, that is 2,000. After deducting this 2,000 from this 24,000, we get annual value of 22,000. From here, you have to deduct municipal tax. Nothing is mentioned whether it is paid or paid by owner. So, we have to assume it is paid and paid by the owner and entire amount is deductible. We get net annual value after deducting this 1,200 from gross annual value. From here, only one deduction is there, that is deduction under section 24 clause A. That is standard deduction at the rate of 30% of NAV. NAV is 20,800 and 30% of this 20,800 is 6,240. After deducting this amount, we get 14,560 as income from first house. Now, here nothing is mentioned for interest on loan, so no question of deducting interest on loan. House 2. This is used as let out for business. Municipal value is given in the question 15,000. Rent received, which is equal to annual rent because there is no vacancy, 36,000. Comparing these two, we get gross annual value. That is higher of the above two, 36,000. From here, municipal tax is deducted. Municipal tax is 1,500 given in the question. After deducting this 1,500, we get 34,500. This is the net annual value. From here, only one deduction because here also no interest on loan is given. Deduction under section 24A, clause A, standard deduction at the rate of 30% of NAV. So, 30% of 34,500 is 10,350. Deducting this 10,350 from 34,500, we get 24,150. This is the income from second house. Now, summation of these two income, income from first house, which is 14,560, and income from second house, that is 24,150, is 30,710, which is the income from house property of the two houses.